one of the questions I get asked the most is, okay, Heather, I'm an empath. I'm highly sensitive. How in the world do I set healthy boundaries for myself around people? Well, today I want you to stay tuned because we're going to be talking about just that. My name is Heather Evans. I'm a self-care and empowerment coach working with empaths and highly sensitive people around the world. If you're ready to live your most empowered life, remember to subscribe to my channel and click on that bell to get notified when I release new videos each week. How do I set healthy boundaries? This is one of the most common questions I get from my clients, and it's a big part of the work that I do with the empaths and the highly sensitive people that I work with. You know, as empaths, as people who are highly sensitive, it's so important that we take time to nourish our systems with the things that are actually aligned for us, that are aligned with our truth, and that enable us to hold space, not only for others, but also for ourselves. And so when it comes to setting healthy boundaries with people, I wanted to share some strategies with you that you can put into place in your life. The first invitation I'd like to offer you is to do a bit of a self audit. I encourage people to do an audit for a week, and this is where you'll notice and take notes on how you're feeling when you're engaging in certain activities. So, as an example of this, let's say that you're making plans to spend time with somebody. You're going to grab tea or coffee, and what I want you to start doing is notice the vibration or the sensation that you have in your system when you're setting up that time. Are you feeling good about it? Are you getting ripples of maybe this isn't such a great idea? How is your gut reacting? Is your stomach in knots, or are you feeling open and receptive? Then I want you to take note of how you're feeling when you're with the person. Is this person energizing for you? Do you feel calm and at ease? Do you feel expansive? Or does your system go into contraction? Do you feel tense and stressed? Do you feel like your energy is getting drained? And then notice how you feel afterwards. Would you want to set up another coffee or tea date with this person? Would you want to avoid that person? By doing and taking the time for these self audits, it enables us to see where our boundaries are. It enables us to see this person is in service and is helping me remain aligned and centered and grounded, versus, oh, this person is taking me off center. By the way, this doesn't just apply to people. It can also apply to situations, but we're focused on the people in our lives right now. So for a week, I'm going to encourage you to notice and take notes, use a journal, use the notes function on your phone, but just notice how you're feeling in your system when you're around people or groups of people. Are they serving you or are they not? One strategy you can use is by creating a 5-point scale, with one being this isn't aligned with my truth or this isn't serving me, to 5, this is completely aligned and I'm feeling really energized and engaged. And this scale can be helpful for you to begin to bracket where you feel most aligned with the people in your life. In the next phase of this, we know that empaths and highly sensitive people can struggle with saying no to others. That no can actually be a very complex word, and it can bring up feelings of guilt or shame or vulnerability. And so what I'd like to encourage you to do is to begin to practice saying no with people you feel safe with. This is a strategy I would like to invite you to employ, and this has worked for my clients in the past, and I wanted to share it with you now. I want you to choose a person that you feel safe and comfortable with, a person that honors who you are and that recognizes your superpower as an empath. And then I want you to have a conversation with them, a conversation in which you share that you're working on saying no, that you're working on honoring your boundaries, and would they be willing to hold you accountable for that? Then what you're going to do is you're going to set up a series of practices. You're going to ask this person to invite you out and let that person know that you're going to say no. Let them know that your response is going to be no. So essentially, we're creating a lab, a test lab, for you to practice saying no with people you're safe with. And then eventually that you can agree that at some point this person won't be prompted to invite you to place. They'll just invite you and they'll allow your response to be what it is, whether it's a yes or a no. The reason we want to do this is we want to practice in a safe space what it's like to say no to somebody who honors and respects us, who knows that we have boundaries and who recognizes that we're working on sticking to and putting in place healthy boundaries for ourselves. This can make a world of difference. By practicing, and our entire life is a practice, so by practicing saying no, it becomes more easeful and it becomes more familiar to the system, whereas before we might have been saying yes without even thinking about it. I hope you found these tips helpful today. I'd like to know which one resonated with you. Is it taking the inventory of how you're feeling and using the 1 to 5 scale, or is it the practicing saying no? Both of these are great ways to start putting healthy boundaries in place for empaths and highly sensitive people alike. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please like it. Remember to subscribe to my channel and click on that bell to get notified when I release new videos each week. Stay ignited out there. I'll see you soon. Bye.